Dear students, in the last lecture, we have seen the flow charts which can derive multiple conditions or which can rather go for multiple conditions. Today we are going to continue with the same topic, flow chart, but we will use what if we need to generate a series. Say for example, if we need to write down a flow chart or draw flow chart, draw flowchart for generating natural numbers from 1 to 10. Is it 1 to 10? What we need the series like this: 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 and up to 10. There are so many ways of doing this. Let us see how we can build the flow chart for this particular thing. The first thing is to start. That means we are going to start and we are going to add here text as start. And after that, what we are going to do, we are going to attach a flow line for that and take the input. Input here means the parallelogram will be inserted here, is it? The parallelogram, as we have seen, the parallelogram is used for taking the input in the flowchart, and we will use like that input say limit equivalent to 10. That means limit will be for how many iterations we need to go. And say for example, we have created one more variable int, an integer or I as a particular variable. And then what we need to attach the flow lines with that. And with flow line, what we are going to do, we are going to have processing statements or processing box. Within the processing box, what we need to write down the statements. But what we need after every iteration, we need whether our particular variable or whether our variable exceeds 10 or not. If it doesn't exceed the value 10, then we need to print it. If we exceeds, then we need to stop. And in order to do so, first what we are going to do, we are going to check the condition. The condition is being checked with the help of this diamond, with this diamond box, the diamond box here. The diamond box here, is it? Diamond box. We will write down like this: if or while. While is, there are loops available within the C, because we are writing in terms of the C. What we need, loops gives us the provision that if we are going to repeat the statement again and again, instead of writing down those statements, we are using loops. We will see the loops here within the coming lectures very broadly, but here we will see that while I less than limit, is it? What we are going to do, we are going to check whether our I, which is equivalent to here 1, is less than limit or not. If it is less than limit, what we are going to do, we are attaching a flow line for that, and we are going to add here text as print the value of I. When I will get printed, that means at the first time it will be 1. Now what we need, because there are statements associated with this, we have seen the if else part, we see that it will be yes. The if else part does have two things, yes and no. And similarly, it has yes and no. Here it will be no. Is it? The yes part will be only executed when the statement will get true, and no part will get executed when the statement will become false. At the first time, I is equivalent to 1. So while I less than equivalent to 1, 1 less than 10 condition is true, so we are going to print I. And with this we are going to have the statements like this. Okay, so we are going to have statement, that means these statements, and we are going to I will be equivalent to i plus 1. That means when I will be equivalent to 1, 1 less than 10 condition is true, print I, that means 1 get printed. Then increment I by 1, it will be previous value of I is equivalent to 1. The new value of I is equivalent to is being incremented by 1. 1 plus 1 it become 2. Check it again. Now the current value of I is 2. 2 less than limit. Limit this value is 10. Is 2 less than limit 10? Yes. It will print 2 and it will increment. It will become 3. Again, is 3 less than 10? Condition is true. It will print 3 again. Then it will be 10 less than 10. Condition will become false. But we need up to 10. So we are going to mention it like that. Less than or equivalent to. Less than or equivalent means either it should be less than or it should be equivalent. 10 less than 10 means 10 is 10 less than or equivalent to 10. Obviously it is true, because 10, one of the condition, it is not less than 10, but it is equivalent to 10. The one of the condition is true, so it will become none, it will become 11. So 11 less than 10 or less than or equivalent to 10, condition will become false, so it's going to be stopped. So in order to stop it, what we need to again add one more symbol, which is stop. So we are going to iterate it again and again and again, and which will generate we people with the series from 1 to 10. Let's take the similar example ke liye hum kya baat karenge, aur ek particular cheez हम देखेंगे इसके लिए जो इसी एग्जांपल के थ्रू हमारे पास आएगी से हम अब चेक करेंगे कि अब हमारे पास ऐसा होगा ड्रॉ ए फ्लो चार्ट विच विल प्रिंट ऑड आर से इवन नंबर्स अप टू से 100 विच विल प्रिंट even numbers for we people up to 100. So let us start drawing the flow chart for this. Say the first thing is to start and we are going to add here start, is it? Now the add the flow line, add the input box, add the input say limit equivalent to 100, that means we need to go up to 100. And what we are going to use, we are going to use a value, is it, comma I will be equivalent to 1. That means we are going to start from 1 and we will end by at 100. So these are the input values we need during the course of the action of this particular program. What we need to add one more flow line. Now we need to check the value of I, is this even or odd? As we have seen in the previous particular lectures or previous videos, that if we are going to make a condition like this, we will write down here like this: while I less than limit. हम बताते हैं इसको तब तक चलते रहो जब तक limit आ जाए. क्यों? हमें एक एक करके इसको manipulate करना है. पहले I होगा 1, उसको check करना है, फिर I होगा 2, उसको check करना है, फिर I होगा 3, उसको check करना है, और एक एक करके सबको check करना है. तो हम क्या करेंगे, हम यहाँ पे yes or no डाल देंगे, is it? Yes or no. Yes. If it is yes, to kahan jayega? Niche. If it is no, to kahan jana chahiye? किसी और डायरेक्शन में, दैट मीन्स दो डायरेक्शन है इसके पास, तो हम दोनों एरो सेट करेंगे, ये एरो फ्लो लाइन और ये वाला, एक यस के लिए एक नो के, इज इट? अगर ये लिमिट यस, अगर ये कंडीशन यस ट्रू रहा, दैट मींस फर्स्ट टाइम ये ट्रू होगा, आई विल बी इक्वलेंट टू वन, वन लेस देन और लेस देन और इक्वलेंट टू 100, ठीक है? सो इफ इट इज यस, व्हाट वी नीड टू चेक अगेन, वी नीड टू ड्रॉ अगेन वन मोर बॉक्स. नाउ ये तो हमारे पास आ गया वाइल लूप से, हमारे पास आ गया 1 2 3 4 5, बट 1 2 3 4 5 चेक करना है कि वेदर दिस नंबर इज इवन और. सो इन ऑर्डर टू चेक हम क्या करते हैं, हमने परसों देखा, हम ऐसे चेक करते हैं, इफ आई परसेंट टू इज इक्वलेंट इक्वलेंट टू जीरो, इज इट? आई परसेंट टू इज इक्वलेंट टू जीरो. परसों भी मैंने बताया इसमें क्या होता है, यहां पे आई परसेंट हमें हमेशा रिमाइंडर देता है. इफ इट इज इक्वलेंट टू जीरो देन इंसर्ट, दैट मींस इफ इट इज इक्वलेंट टू जीरो देन इट इज एन इवन नंबर, इज इट? अगर ये इवन नंबर है तो इसको क्या करो, प्रिंट करो. तो हम क्या करेंगे, प्रिंट द वैल्यू ऑफ, इज इट? यहां पर भी दो कंडीशन होंगे सिमिलर, हम क्या करेंगे इसको अटैच कर देंगे एक कॉपी, एंड यहां पर भी यस होगा और यहां पर भी सिमिलरली होगा नो होगा. हम क्या कर रहे हैं, पहले चेक कर रहे हैं वेदर इटरेट कर रहे हैं, पहले जनरेट करते हैं 1 to 100, फिर उसके बाद एक एक करके आई जब 1 होगा उसको क्रॉस चेक करते हैं कि ये 2 से डिविजिबल है, 3 होगा उससे डिविजिबल है, 4 होगा उससे डिविजिबल है, ठीक है? अगर ये प्रिंट, अगर ये डिविजिबल हुआ तो प्रिंट करेंगे, और साथ साथ में हम क्या करेंगे, आई विल बिकम आई प्लस 1. जब आई विल बिकम आई प्लस 1 तो हम क्या करेंगे, इसको ऐसे ऊपर, दैट मींस फर्स्ट टाइम आई विल बिकम 1 1% 2 नॉट इक्वलेंट टू 0, तो क्या होगा, हम डायरेक्टली आई को इंक्रीमेंट करवाएंगे क्योंकि उस टाइम पे हमें कुछ प्रिंट नहीं करना है. So I will get incremented. So I will get incremented here. Add I will be equivalent to I plus 1. Is it? Now we are going to attach flow lines for that. Is it? Now if we are going to compile it again, add the no. What we are going to stop. That means ये अब आगे नहीं चलेगा. So let me define it again now. Because अब हमने पूरा ये कर दिया. Okay. So let us start. First one is take the input. मैंने limit लिया 100 और I equivalent to 1. मैं पहले क्या कर रहा हूँ? पहले एक-एक करके generate कर रहा हूँ और साथ साथ में उसको check भी कर रहा हूँ कि ये even number है. तो पहली बार होगा I less than or equivalent to limit. That means I less than or equivalent to limit is I current value of I is 1. Is 1 less than or equivalent to limit? Obviously it is, because 1 is less than or equivalent to 100. It is always less than, so it will go to the yes part. यहाँ पे क्या check करेगा? Is I percent two equivalent to zero? That means is our reminder 1% two equivalent to zero? It is not, because I जब one को divide करते हैं two से तो obviously reminder will become one. One is not equivalent to zero, so it will go to the no part and it will increment the I. Now I will become 2. So 2 जब बनेगा, sorry, we need to write it, we need to go it here. is it? And we need to edit here. So I will be equivalent to I plus 1, that it will become 2. 2 less than or limit, obviously 2 is not, 2 is obviously less than limit. So what it will go to the yes part. 2% 2, that means 2 divided by 2, remainder is equivalent to 0. That means 0 equivalent to 0. Condition is true, it will print I. That means 2 will get printed. One of the even number get printed. Now I will be again incremented. Sorry, it will be here. I will be incremented, so increment I by 1, it will become 2, so 2 will get again checked, while 2 less than limit, 2 less than limit, obviously it is 2 less than limit. So what we are going to do, it will be, is 2% 2 equivalent equivalent 0, it will get printed as 2. Now 3 will get, 3 is going to be add here, I will get incremented by 1, so it will be 3, 3. Again, we are going to check whether 3 is less than limit. Obviously, it is. So, it is going to check is 3% 2 equivalent equivalent 0, but it's not. The when we are going to divide 3 by 2, the remainder is always equivalent to 1. 1 is not double. 1 is not equivalent to 0. Then it will go to the no part, and we are going to add it here. And it will repeat on the things again and again until and unless the condition will become false. So when 101 will get, I will get 101 as value, which is less than or equivalent to limit. That means 101 is less than or equivalent to 100, then it's going to stop. This is how loops exist within our data flow charts. Hope you understand the concept of, a big concept of loops, but we are going to take it again within the future classes. Thank you very much for today's lecture.